It's a pretty surreal feeling. For the first time after 2013 I started, so it's the first race win we've had this afternoon today here at Winton, so pretty good feeling, pretty stoked.
Settling in, and looks like we've had a spin there, Daz, out the back of the circuit. Around the gum tree, that's the Westaway car.
That's our race leader.
That's Jamie.
Oh, Jamie Westaway.
Wow, that's Jamie Westaway. That's the champion, Jamie Westaway, and he is getting out of the car. Now, I'm not sure what's happened there, but that is out the back of the circuit by the looks of it, under the gum tree.
Due to his unfortunate gearbox failure, was in the position to take the lead.
Wow, that's a
five. Throw it wide open now, Mark.
5 second lead, exactly. Guess who's in front of the race? It's El Presidente, Mark Taubitz.
Look, for me, it's you know, it's what I've been trying to get to for a number of years.
This gap is slowly being pegged back as Lewis Williams and Ads Brewer start to work together a little bit in the last couple of laps.
Right, here we go, because Mark Taubitz has never won a race in all the years he's been racing.
You know, when I started, sort of thought, yep, hopefully once I learn, I'll be able to race up with these guys at the pointy end.
Championships, he's never won a race. Well, Mr. Taubitz and El Presidente, here is your chance, but you've got a four-time champion right on your bumper, and you've got the Black Widow Spider, number 3, who's catching him as well.
I could see him coming in my mirrors.
Mark Taubitz is absolutely driving the wheels off this car. And
I knew I didn't want them to catch me because they were going to apply the blowtorch if they did. But
at the moment, Mark Taubitz poised for a victory.
Wow. Can he do it? He's really coming under pressure there from a guy who knows how to win a race and knows how to win a championship. And that's Chris Lewis Williams, the Baron of Benalla, the number 37. And you can see the black car there of Adam Brewer there, hunting him down.
I reckon I did the last lap 4 times in my head anyway.
He's probably got a lap or two to go, and he would be looking in his mirrors and left and right, because he has never won a race.
Just never quite had the quite had the machinery to be able to dice with him.
I'm absolutely got fingers, toes and anti-sway bars all crossed up at the moment for Mark Taubitz, because I know that he just puts so much effort into this category. This would just make his year if he could jag a win here.
And I knew that they'd catch me, but I knew also I was going to be a little bit kinder on the rear tyres, because it was very hot out there today, and the tyres were cooked after a few laps already. So I was just nursing them home, and I wanted to have something to fight with if they did catch me.
He's a guitarist in a heavy metal band.
Real heavy.
And he's driving a bright yellow car.
It's a real heavy band, and I can tell you I've seen that band, and it takes you about 3 or 4 days to recover.
It was a long race, especially those last half a dozen laps or whatever it was after Jamie pulled off and I was in the lead. The checkered flag couldn't come out soon enough.
Puts hours and hours and hours behind the scenes into this category. He is much deserving of a race victory. And it's fantastic to see the yellow pipe craft car glistening in the Winton sunshine as he comes up to the final corner. He's got one corner to go, and he's going to hold off Chris Lewis Williams and Adam Brewer. And it is just almost emotional, actually.
So, but it was a great feeling when I saw Andy Baller and my brother on the pit wall celebrating as I came to the checkered flag for the first time in the league.
He gets out on the ripple strips there, and Lewis Williams is going to have this gap back under 1 second. There's the checkered flag. Mark Taubitz can finally breathe again.
Hey.
Gets to the line, and that's a victory, and a sweet, sweet victory indeed it is for the driver of car number 66, Mark Taubitz.
And, couldn't do it without the help of my uncle, my brothers, my dad, and my partner, and also the Bellas have been the best, so they've helped me get all this done. So I can't thank them enough, but I have to thank both Andrew Jackman for letting me use his car the last for 3 rounds last year, which I got my first pole position at Sandown last year. So I guess that was the first time I could sort of, I was able to prove that I could race up and be up at the pointy end. Couldn't do it without them, and obviously Timmy Wolf, because I got his car.
CLW has just driven up beside him, and he has given him the thumbs up.
Yep. No, I think the whole category will be shedding a tear and having a beer tonight, because that's fantastic to see Mark Taubitz come across the line there.
Formed an incredibly close friendship with pretty much all the guys in the series, and you know, that's the best part of going racing, is that we're racing here with our mates. You know, we go away to a weekend like Winton, we camp together, we go out for dinner together, we laugh together, we go racing, we race hard, and we just have such a ball doing it. You know, I've made some amazing lifelong friends through racing here in 944s. That's just as much enjoyment as the actual racing, is doing all that stuff as well.
What a race.